Hi friends, welcome once again. In our previous session, we have discussed up to this point. Now we will discuss the last topic of the agitation and mixing, that is the agitator scale-up. Agitator scale-up. First, write introduction. In the process industries. In the process industries, experimental data are often available for a laboratory size. For pilot unit size, agitation system. This topic is important because in last 5 years they asked 2 to 3 questions from this section of 2 marks. Size agitation system, and it is desired. And it is desired to scale up. The results. Scale up the results to design a full scale unit. To design a full scale unit. Since the processes. Scale up means you already know from the lab to the land. Since the processes to be scaled up, are very diverse. No single method can handle all types of scale-up problems. And many approaches. To scale up exist. Geometric similarity. Is of course important and simplest in fluid mechanics. We have already discussed about the similarities and etc. Important and simplest to achieve kinematic similarity. Kinematic similarity can be defined in terms of ratios, in terms of the ratios of, in terms of the ratios of the velocities or of times dynamic similarities requires fixed ratios of forces, fixed ratios of viscous internal, viscous inertial and gravitational forces and gravitational forces even if geometric similarity is achieved geometric similarity is achieved dynamic and kinematic kinematic similarity similarity often cannot be obtained cannot be obtained at the same time so we can say hence it is frequently up to the designer frequently up to the designer to rely on judgment and experience in the scalar and experience in the scalar Is it clear? So it was just about introduction. So in many cases, the main objectives usually present in an agitation process are as follows equal liquid motion such as blending such as in liquid blending such as in liquid blending where the liquid motion or corresponding velocities are approximately the same are approximately the same in both cases? Are approximately the same in both cases? Equal liquid motion. Then equal suspension of solids. Equal suspension of solids, where the levels of suspension are the same. Equal suspension of solids. And equal rate of mass transfer, based on this concept they asked question, equal rate of mass transfer, equal rate of mass transfer. Equal rate of mass transfer, where mass transfer, here mass transfer is occurring between a liquid and a solid phase. And so on. And the rates are the same. And the rates are the same. Is it clear? Write down second scale up procedure. All these are skipped topic by you and your faculties, but in GATE exam, they ask questions from this section, and in future also they will ask. Scale up procedures. So I suggested step-by-step procedure. Step-by-step procedure. Step-by-step procedure. Step-by-step procedure to follow in the scale-up. Is detailed as follows. Is detailed as follows. For scaling up from the initial condition, from the initial condition, where the geometric sizes, where the geometric sizes are dA1, dT1, H1, W1, and so on to the final conditions, to the final conditions of, to the final conditions of dA2, dT2, and so on. Write down first one. Calculate the calculate the scale of ratio. Calculate the scale of ratio R, assuming that the original vessel, is a standard cylinder. With DT1 is equal to H1. So the volume is area into height. So the volume V1 is. So V1 is equal to pi into DT1 square. I have already told you the notation, what is DT, what is DA. Divided by 4 into H1. But H1 is equal to DT1. Then you will get pi into DT1 cube divided by 4. So the ratio of the volumes is V2 by V1 is equal to pi into DT2 cube divided by 4, pi into DT1 cube divided by 4, pi will cancel out, 4 and 4 will cancel out, so DT2 by DT1 cube. So then the scale up ratio they will ask question 100%, all these are future concept of gate. The scale up ratio is then R is equal to V2 by V1 to the power 1 by 3. So it is T2 by DT1. So using this value of R, apply it to the whole dimension, the dimension you want to calculate, to whole dimension, to calculate the new dimension, to calculate the new dimensions. For example, DA2 is equal to R into DA1, J2 is equal to R into J1, etc. Third one, then a scale up rule must be selected and applied to determine the agitator speed N2 to be used to duplicate the small scale results, using N1. So we have general equation N2 is equal to N1 1 by R to the power N, or is equal to n1 into dt1 dt2 to the power n. Very small things where n is equal to 1. All these are very wonderful concepts. N is equal to 1 for equal liquid motion. Equal liquid motion. N is equal to 3 by 4 for equal suspension of solids. For equal suspension of solids. N is equal to 2 by 3 for equal rates of mass transfer. For equal rates of mass transfer, which is equivalent to equal power per unit volume. Equal power per unit volume. Equal power per unit volume. So please mug up all these situations. Very, very important. Directly 2-2 marks question you will get from these sections. So knowing the value of n2, we will calculate the power required. We will calculate the power required. Power required. We will calculate the power required. Okay, we are going to prove it. The power per unit volume. We are going to prove it. Let's see. The power per unit volume. The power per unit volume. Is given by the power per unit volume is given by and I already told you that geometric similarity is maintained. So power per unit volume, power is equal to from the power number np into n cube dA to the power 5 into rho divided by pi by 4 dt square h. Can we write like this? 4 np rho into pi dA by dt square. All these are standard ratios. dA by h n cube dA square. N cube dA square. N cube dA square. So this complete is constant, and for constant four constants, power per unit volume, we can write n cube dA square is equal to constant. Or we can write n1 cube dA1 square, n2 cube dA2 square. Can we write like this? N2 by n1, n2 by n1 cube, dA1 by dA2 square, or n2 by n1, dA1 by dA2, 2 by 3. Same thing. In such a manner, they go 2 by 3. Just for your sake of knowledge, I derived it. Remember all these basic things. Now we will solve questions related to this concept. Otherwise, you will think sir is going to teach so much, because most of you are doing all these concepts first time. And even 50% students who are here already took coaching from various coachings. Is it clear? Very good. So I hope it should be clear to each and every student. Tell me the number of questions that we have discussed till now. The number of questions that we have discussed. The number of questions that we have discussed. 55, very good. Write down question number 56. Gate 2008, 2 marks. If you know the concept without touching pen, you will solve. Consider the scale up. Consider the scale up of a cylindrical baffled vessel configured to have the standard geometry, height is equal to diameter, so in order to maintain an equal rate of mass transfer, they ask question directly. Equal rate of mass transfer. Maybe at that time you were thinking, sir, what is this equal rate of mass transfer under turbulent conditions? Under turbulent condition for a Newtonian fluid. So the ratio of the agitator speeds should be within brackets n1 d1 are agitator speed and vessel diameter before scale up and n2, d2 are the is before scale up and it is after scale up. We have options n1 by n2 is equal to d1 by d2. Second one is n1 by n2 is equal to d2 by d1. Third one is n1 by n2 is equal to d1 by d2 to the power 2 by 3, and n1 by n2 is equal to d2 by d1 to the power 2 by 3. So if you know the concept, this question is very easy for you. And but if you don't know the concept, then this question is totally rocket science type for you. And in subject like MO, mechanical operation, we are going to solve 65 questions in classroom. No one will solve. And it is the main reason that our selection ratio is very high, more than 70 to 80% selection ratio. Only gyan, no bakwas like others. Is it clear? The right answer of this question is, without touching the pen, tell me the right answer of this question. Ganesh, Siddharth, very good. D is the correct answer. So the right answer of this question is D. Again, similar type of question they ask. Yeah, already told you, as question size increases, its difficulty level decreases. Write down question number 57. Question number 57. GATE 2016. Again 2 marks. An agitated vessel. I told you 3 conditions. 1 condition they already asked. In future they will ask remaining 2 conditions. An agitated cylindrical vessel, an agitated cylindrical vessel is fitted with baffles, is fitted with baffles and flat blade impellers, and flat blade impellers. The power number for this system is given by NP is equal to P by rho into N cube D to the power 5. Where P is the power consumed for the mixing. P is the power consumed for the mixing. Power consumed for the mixing. Rho is the density of the fluid. Rho is the density of the fluid. N is the speed of the impeller. N is the speed of the impeller. And D is the diameter of the impeller. D is the diameter of the impeller. D is the diameter of the impeller. Full stop. The diameter of the impeller. The diameter of the impeller. The diameter of the impeller is 1/3 of the diameter of the tank. diameter of the tank and the height of liquid level and the height of liquid level and the height of liquid level is equal to the tank diameter is equal to the tank diameter the impeller speed the impeller speed to achieve the desired degree of mixing desired degree of mixing desired degree of mixing is 4 pm 4 rpm in a scaled up design in a scaled up design the linear dimensions the linear dimensions of the equipment are to be doubled of the equipment are to be doubled holding the power input per unit volume constant per unit volume constant per unit volume constant assume the liquid to be Newtonian assume the liquid to be Newtonian and NP is the and NP to be independent of Reynolds number independent of Reynolds number then what is the impeller speed what is the impeller speed in rpm to achieve the same degree of mixing to achieve the same degree of mixing in the scaled up vessel so if you know the concept then you are able to solve otherwise you need to skip this question I need answer from each and every student what is the solution of this Right answer of this question is after that one more future gate question you need to apply directly formula n2 is equal to n1 d1 by d2 to the power 2 by 3 put the value and you will get directly formula based question Question size is of one page, solution is of one line only. Very good. How many of you got it? Very good, very good, very good. Third, third. So 2.52 is the correct answer. Very good. Write down one future gate question. Question number 58. Question number 58. Write down very nice question. We have an agitation system we have an agitation system 4A flat blade turbine. With a disc and six blades, and these six blades and six blades, the given conditions and sizes are the given condition and sizes are DT1 is equal to 1.83 meter, DA1 0.61 meter, W1 is equal to 0.122 meter, J1 is equal to 0.15 meter, N1 is equal to 90 by 60, 1.50 revolution per second. Rho is equal to 929 kg per meter cube and mu is equal to 0.01 pascal second. So it is desired to scale up these results. To scale up these results for a vessel whose volume is three times as large, do this for the following two processes. For the following two processes, following two process objectives. First, equal rate of mass transfer achieved. Equal rate of mass transfer is desired. Second one, where equal liquid motion is needed. And it is an agitation system where H1 is equal to DT1. Now solve it. Very nice question. It is a future gate question. Okay, let's solve it. We have H1 is equal to DT1 is equal to 1.83 meter. So the original tank volume, V1 is equal to pi into DT1 square by 4 into H1. So pi by 4 into 1.83 cube, because H1 is equal to DT1. Is equal to 4.813 meter cube. The volume V2 is equal to 3 times of this one, 14.44 meter cube. We know that, calculate the value of R. R is equal to V2 by V1 to the power 1 by 3. So 14.44 divided by 4.813, 1.442. So the dimension of larger system, remember step 2, the dimension of the larger agitation system. Larger agitation system are as follows. So DT2 is equal to R into DT1, 1.442 into 1.83, 2.64 meter. In similar manner, DA2 is equal to 1.442 into 1.442 into 0.61, that is 0.880 meter. W2 is equal to 1.442 into 0.112, 0.176 meter. J2 is equal to 1.442 into 0.15 is equal to 0.216 meter. Now we will solve first part. For first part, we have for equal mass transfer, N2 is equal to N1, 1 by R to the power 2 by 3, because N is equal to 2 by 3. So 1.50 divided by into 1 by 1.442 to the power 2 by 3. The value of N2 is equal to 1.175. revolution per second, 470.5 RPM. Is it clear? If we want to calculate the Reynolds number, then d a square n into rho by mu 0.880 square 1.175 929 0.01 8.453 into 10^4. So power is equal to np into rho into n2 cube into d a to the power 5. They will provide you in exam the value of NP. The NP value is 5 from the graph. But in exam they will provide you that for this Reynolds number that what is the value of power, NP power number. So P2 is equal to 5 into 9.29 1.175 cube 0.880 to the power 5, 3977 joule per second or 3.977 kilowatt. Next one is the power per unit volume. The power per unit volume is P1 by V1 1.324 divided by 4.813 0.275, just for your sake of knowledge, because I told you now that in the case of equal rate of mass transfer the power per unit volume should be constant, so we are just cross check kilowatt per meter cube. So check P2 by V2 3.977 14.44. It means our analysis is absolutely correct. Sometimes we can cross check just like that. Is it clear? Very good. So it is also a better way. Suppose if you are going to get any question in gate, then with the help of options, just check that the power per unit volume should be satisfied. Then also you will get the right answer. Second part. For equal liquid motion, that is n is equal to 1, so the value of n2 is equal to n1 into 1 by r to the power 1, so 1.50 1.040 revolution per second. So P2 is equal to 5 into 929 into 1.040 cube into 0.880 to the power 5. 2757 joule per second kilowatt. So P2 by V2 is equal to 2.757 0.1909 kilowatt per meter cube. I hope I did a small mistake. Here it should be 929, not 9.29. 929. So in such a manner, you are able to solve such type of difficult questions also. And I already told you in GATE exam, only you need only 5 questions, 5 additional questions to be ranked. Is it clear? So I hope you enjoyed this session also. How many of you got it yourself? So I hope you enjoyed this session also. Thank you very much. Keep learning, keep smiling, be happy, and keep revising also. If you have any doubt at any point, just ask without any hesitation. So today we will finish the mechanical operation also with 65 questions, and I hope it is the 24th lecture. In total 26 lectures, nearly 30 hours, we will finish it. Is it clear? That is the basic difference between us. Now I can say one thing confidently, that now every one of you can solve all these questions in a very simple manner. Is it clear? Thank you very much.